HTC, a brand that is instantly associated nowadays with low revenue and profits, was not always like this. Let us see one of its mid-range offerings from its heyday. In February of 2007, HTC launched the P3400, a pocket PC that ran on the ubiquitous Microsoft Windows Mobile 5 platform.
Up front, on top, is the loud enough earpiece that houses notification LEDs embedded into a polycarbonate body. The 2.8-inch TFT resistive touchscreen is present between an array of buttons and the aforementioned earpiece.
On the left is a volume rocker along with a speaker grill, about which I will talk later. On the right is a camera button and a button for summoning the built-in voice command assistant, both of which are remappable. You can see that on the top right is the slot for stylus. The top of the phone has an SD card slot and the power button, which doubles as a sleep wake button.
At the bottom of the phone is a microphone, a reset button and a mini USB port which can be used for charging, data syncing and for plugging in a pair of earphones, as this device lacks a 3.5mm audio jack. And finally, we come to the back, which has a fixed focus 2-megapixel camera, and you can remove the back panel to gain access to the battery and SIM card slot.
An SD card is imperative, as the internal storage is just 128MB. The processor is clocked at 201MHz and 64MB of RAM is available to run the programs. Despite being 17.6mm thick and weighing 126g, this phone lacks a physical keyboard. The cause of thickness might be the 1250mAh battery, which might sound puny now, but you could squeeze up to one day of usage back in the day. This is because the chipset is not that power hungry and it doesn't have to drive many pixels. Speaking about the screen, it is resistive and its resolution is 240 by 320 pixels, which results in about 143 ppi. The viewing angles are not that great, brightness is less than desirable, and colors appear to be washed out. Don't get me wrong, this screen is not that awful, but it is not that great. You can say that it is creditable. Navigating through the phone and performing day-to-day tasks is reasonably smooth without any major lag, but there are some sporadic stutters. For typing, you have to use the software keyboard and stylus. It might be difficult at first because any kind of feedback is absent, but you get used to it after some time. What you will not have any difficulty in using and getting used to are those buttons. They are the epitome of tactility. Not the buttons on either side though. They are mushy and they lack good feedback. They could be a bit more tactile. Let's talk about media consumption. The speaker is commendable. It is adequately loud and clear. Here is a sample. The sound tends to distort at high volumes, but it gets the job done. The camera is a 2-megapixel fixed focus shooter. Photos come out to be decent, but the same cannot be said about videos. They are choppy and the overall quality is bad.
Have a look at a sample photo and a video.
Overall, it can take some decent photographs, but cannot be relied upon for good videos. It also lacks a flash, so photography in low light is a bit difficult. Now, for storing all those media files, you cannot depend on the internal storage of the phone, as it is measly 128MB. An SD card is necessary, as you see here. So, what is this phone like? Its performance is good. You get several Microsoft programs like Word, Excel, Zip, PDF Reader, and many more. You also get a voice command feature that you can summon quickly by pressing the side button. It can help you with some basic tasks like playing music, calling someone, creating a memo, and other similar steps. The number of applications that it supports is limited and cannot be extended. It could have been much more useful, but the speech recognition system is bad, and most of the time, it fails in understanding you. It runs offline, and fortunately so. As for connectivity, this phone doesn't offer 3G nor Wi-Fi and GPS. You are stuck with 2G. This means that web browsing is slow, but holding the phone for long durations will not leave any lasting impressions on your hand, as this phone is very comfortable to hold. The comfort is buttressed by the soft touch plastic on the back and on all sides, but this plastic is prone to fingerprints and smudges, and it gets scratched pretty easily.
Overall, this phone, for its time, offers great performance and has some good features. The downsides are its mediocre camera and insufficient internal storage. In my opinion, it is safe to say that this phone was great for the price it was being offered at, if you could look past the camera deficiencies.